Today we'll be going over how to generate leads in Salesforce by using a webhook and Google Ads lead form extensions. To start, we're going to create a custom metadata type to store our Google key and an optional email address for email notification purposes. We'll create one record for this custom metadata type and store our information in the proper fields. A custom metadata type is used rather than storing the information in Apex, both as a general best practice and for making the updating process easy if you wish to update the key or email address. Once that record is created, we'll be making a custom object to store any errors that may happen with the webhook. We will create one custom field for this object called error message, which is just a long text area that will store whatever error may pop up. Now we'll be creating our Apex class that is actually going to generate our lead from that form and also send out our optional email notification. In this Apex class, you'll be using REST resource and an HTTP post. You'll grab the request body sent from the Google Ads lead form, and you're going to parse through all that data. You'll want to perform some error handling and have any errors that may pop up sent to your custom error object. After you've parsed through the data and done your error handling, you'll create a new lead record using the information from your request body. If you are wanting to send out an email notification for your new lead, you'll create a separate method that uses the messaging class. Use your new lead as a parameter and query for your notification email address that was saved on your custom metadata type. You'll set up your email's body and include any information you choose. After setting the body, you'll set the send to address, reply to, and any other relevant information you wish. Once that's set up, you'll create a custom site in Salesforce that will bridge the gap between Salesforce and Google Ads. Create a new site in Salesforce, and after creating this site, save the site's URL. You'll need this for the Google Ads lead form extensions webhook portion, and then be sure that your site is active. Select the Public Access Settings button that's up towards the top of the screen. This brings you to the profile that was created for this specific site. It created a guest user profile, which you'll want to give access to your Apex class. And if you are sending an email notification, you'll want to be sure to give this profile access to send email. After creating your site and setting up the profile for it, you're going to then create your lead form in Google Ads. Once that form is created, you're going to set up the webhook information. At the bottom of the lead form you just created, there is a section labeled Export Leads from Google Ads. Under Other Data Integration Options, you'll insert your site URL from the site you created in Salesforce into the webhook URL section and insert your key that is saved in your custom metadata type. After inserting those, you'll select Send Test Data at the bottom, and after receiving a success message, a new test lead should be generated in your Salesforce org, and your optional notification email should be sent. Go back into Salesforce and verify that the lead was generated. After verifying that your lead has been created and all the information has been populated according to your Apex class, you're all set to create leads from your Google Leads form. If you would like to see this integrated into your Salesforce org, contact DB Services today and we'll help you automate your lead records from Google Ads lead form. Thank you.